the number one thing that is going to keep me going are all these interviews, because all these moms inspire me, every single one. Welcome to Working Mom Warrior, where mothers of all different backgrounds share the ups and downs and hacks of juggling career and kids to help you relate and feel better about the job you're doing as a mother and a professional. You can call me Moca Mom. This is my vlog. I'm sharing the ups and downs of my life. It was 4 years ago on Mother's Day when I was determined to take a step to launch a TV show by and about and for working moms. And I had done a news story about Kickstarter and learned all about this cool thing where people can learn about something creative that you want to do and then contribute to it because they think it's a great idea and you can offer them some incentives. And I spent a lot of time creating a project on this Kickstarter platform and coming up with incentives and sending it out, and it completely flopped. I spent some time and money putting together a video. I really had a long script, what some might even call a sales funnel, that I had created, and it was too long, and there wasn't enough interest to keep people really listening and watching, they told me later, because it was perhaps repetitive, except to someone who might be in the thick of it, which I was at the time. The thick of it being just feeling overwhelmed by working and raising kids. So I never forgot about this dream to do this project, but I wasn't going to get a big chunk of money through Kickstarter to do it. And I had to focus on making money because paying the bills was still a priority, and there wasn't a clear path how to do that with both my husband and I in fields that were low paying and were decimated by changing technology and the recession. And I put this aside, you might say, even though it was always there in the back of my mind. But when I went to a mastermind group meeting after listening to one of Napoleon Hill's Law of Success audiobooks and determining that this is definitely my definite major purpose, as he would say, and I went to the mastermind and met someone who I really connected with, and she basically took on the role of life coach for me because she is a newly certified life coach, building up her coaching business and starting this mastermind as a way to not just promote it, but create a mastermind to improve the lives of herself and others. And she really gave me the motivation and the accountability to make some commitments and then follow through on them. And so it was getting close to a new year, and this is the year I wanted to launch it. And I knew that I wanted to have it, my YouTube channel, launched by April. I decided that the best way to take this journey of getting a regular show on television, old time, old school medium, was to do it through YouTube and create a channel and get a following first, because that's what doomed my Kickstarter channel, is that I didn't have a following. I think there are people out there that are interested in my message, want to hear my message, need to hear my message, will be helped by hearing my message. And of course, the whole idea of it is it's not just my message, it's the message of all the working moms, especially all the working moms who feel that they're not living up to what they want to be. And I want to meet them and talk to them and hear from them and hear their frustrations and hear how they get past their frustrations and hear from the moms who maybe aren't as frustrated as some of us and what they want to do to get past it. And I knew that this message would resonate, but I have to not just tell people I want to do this, I have to do it. And I have to put it up there and I have to find the audience. So I had shot some stuff previously, you know, 3-4 years ago, and I was worried I wouldn't be able to find that footage and remember where I was going with it, but I was so grateful that I did do some backups of my old computer. I did find that footage. And the main profile that's been rolling around in my head for these 3-4 years, I wrote it without even going back and looking at my notes. That's how much I knew this story and how impactful that story was on me, and I believe will be on other people. And so this is the journey that I've been going on since last fall. It's been about 6 months. It's May 2019. It's Mother's Day today, 2019. And my goal was to launch my YouTube channel in April and to have one produced video once a week. I was going to do it on Thursdays, but I first one was on Tuesday, and so I'm doing them on Tuesdays now. And I did a bunch of research and watched a bunch of videos about how to launch a channel and what to do to create a good video and what elements are needed. And I learned about keywords and thumbnails and end screens and didn't know any of that. And I just knew how to produce content, and I showed it to just a very select few people. And the feedback that I got was that it needed some sort of context. I had not created an introduction and a summary at the end. And this is something, even coming from the world of broadcast, I know anytime I put together a news package for a newscast, it was the anchor that introduced it. And I needed to be that anchor. I needed to be the anchor, the host of this. And I needed people to be invited in to my world and what I experienced and why I was trying to seek out these answers from others and why I picked those topics and what they meant to me and others. And so I tried to make sure that those introductions and summaries at the end were not too long. And I unfortunately don't like the talking head format and wanted to get away from that, which is why I wanted to just go straight into a video package where we see somebody doing something right away, straight into soundbite after soundbite, a series of the same question answered by different people. But as I was told by other people, and I'm smart enough now after all the years of making mistakes to listen to feedback from others and adjust as a result, I knew that there needed to be some introduction and some context. And so I did that. So I actually, before I launched, had 3 produced pieces, actually 4, and just needed to get together all of the ancillary elements, like I said, the thumbnails and the descriptions and things like that. To make these as good as I want them, I need to make sure that I'm constantly getting new interviews, and I want to start asking some critical questions that are coming up that I haven't asked yet before I produce the next video, so I can focus on the topic that I think is best, not just necessarily the one that happens to be the common thread running through a lot of the interviews. I hope that you subscribe to Working Mom Warrior and click on the next video for more inspiration, and I look forward to hearing from you in the comments.